There's been a long line of World War II movies since the war actually ended in 1945. Dambusters and the Battle of Britain strive to tell the true story of the heroes who fought to keep Britain safe. And the latest film to tackle the triumphs as well as the horrors of war is Dunkirk, of course based on the experience of the soldiers that were trapped on the beaches of France and the German war machine surrounded them. But did you know that many historians believe the pilot in the film who ditches his Spitfire in the sea and survives is based on the real life experience of Jack Potter? And Jack was an RAF pilot born in Wallasey, and now Wirral Council wants to honour him by naming a street after him. Now, I'll be getting the reaction from Jack's son Rob in a moment, but first let's speak to Heritage Champion Councillor Jerry Williams. Good morning.
Good morning, Janice. Lovely to speak to you.
and you. So, this is a real-life hero, isn't it? A real Wirral hero.
Very, very much so. The pilots of this period of time, and of course Jack Potter had joined the RAF very, very early on. He was a very accomplished pilot, and of course he's going over to stop the German bombers attacking the troops, trying to escape from Dunkirk. And it really is quite an amazing story. In the film itself, they don't mention the historical figures, but the figure who ditches his or pancakes his Spitfire into the channel is Jack Potter. And his Spitfire went down in 10 seconds, would you believe it?
Wow.
Literally 10 seconds, and he got out. He was lucky to land it near to some of the little ships and all the various boats that were going backwards and forwards from Dunkirk. But yeah, truly an amazing story. And Wirral has a very positive heritage street naming policy. We have had it for many, many years, and we've had one of the Cockleshell heroes was from Birkenhead, and we've suitably named a road. This might not just be a road, this could be an esplanade as well.
Oh.
It could be on the corner to the docks going into the Great Float on the Wallasey side. So, we're so pleased to have contacted Rob Potter, who I spoke to yesterday. It was quite an emotional conversation live on BBC South East. But yes, it really is an exceptional story. And the irony of this was, a month and a half, 2 months later, Jack had to land his Spitfire in the channel again. He was picked up by the German sea rescue, and he was a prisoner of war for 4.5 years.
Yes. And have you managed to involve the family in any of this?
Well, this is the great thing about the story. I mean, yesterday we've been on BBC Radio South East, BBC Brighton, because the family were in, I corresponded with Battle of Britain pilots in the 1970s, and I actually wrote to Jack's family. He sadly died, so I knew the family were in Brighton. So BBC South East and also Radio Brighton have been trying to trace the family, and they've traced the family. And yesterday they came on to me in the middle of the TV program and radio program, and they got hold of Rob Potter, and we spoke for the first time. And of course, not only was this fantastically interesting, Jack's father, Jack Potter's father, was on the Mersey. He was a captain on the Mersey ferries.
Wow. Well, let's bring in Rob now. How are you?
Good morning. I'm very well, as you'd expect.
Jolly good and very excited, I would have thought.
Yeah, I am.
How much did you know about your father's heroism?
Well, I knew the story of the ditching and the being picked up by the Jolly Mascotte, which was a French fishing boat rather than one of the English little ships. So it was just part of the family background, and I knew it because I've got a two-page carbon of the report that he wrote about it, which was quite matter of fact, and actually rather more exciting than the film, because after he was picked up, they went to Dunkirk and tried to tow a wrecked destroyer off the beach.
Really?
Stood off it twice while it was bombed again by the Germans.
Wow.
Gave up because the second time the Germans actually managed to hit it. Took some sailors and crew off the ship, and then brought them back to England. And as they went away, watched the Navy shell the destroyer, which was called the Basilisk, to stop it falling into German hands. So I knew all of that.
Yes.
But I didn't know anything about what was in the film until literally 2 weeks ago. I went with one of my sons to see it. We sat there. At the end of it, we looked at each other. We thought, that's a familiar story. He knew it because I told it.
Yes.
And then after that, came back home, because I was up in Lincoln at the time, to find messages from people saying the BBC want you. And I didn't know about any of this. So 2 weeks before I saw the film, the Daily Mail had featured it in an article on the Harbour Master, but there was a sidebar about Jack Potter landing his plane. I hadn't seen any of that.
Gosh. So you're watching the movie. He's not named, is he?
No.
What did you feel about that?
Well, I think Christopher Nolan says that he doesn't name anybody because it's meant to sort of symbolise stuff. And I'm cool with that because enough people now know that was my dad.
Yes.
And the story in the film is not the same. I mean, the ditching is the same, but Dad's hood, cockpit hood, didn't get stuck because he'd had the forethought to open it before he landed.
Yeah.
And what happened afterwards to him, you know, going to the beach, the basilisk and all the rest of it, was actually much more exciting than what was in the film. So I don't feel fussed about it at all.
No. And, of course, you've got lots of photographs of here, memorabilia.
Oh, yes. I've got his medals. I mean, they're just what he would call cookhouse medals. That, you know, everybody got, you know, Battle of Britain, Star Class, Aircrew Europe, 39, 45 star, that sort of thing. My brother reminds me that he did get recommended for a Distinguished Flying Medal.
Right.
He didn't get it.
Oh.
But lots of people didn't get medals. You know, they did what they had to do and didn't get sort of conspicuously rewarded for it. So he's just another one. You know.
But the big reward here is an Esplanade.
Yes, brilliant. You know, 40 years to the year after he died, he gets 15 minutes of fame. It's wonderful.
It's fantastic, isn't it?
Yeah.
And he's a legend in Wirral.
Well, he will be now.
It's just such an amazing story. I absolutely love it. Jerry, any idea when the street's naming is likely to be carried out?
Well, at this moment of time, we're particularly looking at this Esplanade area.
Yeah.
So hopefully it's not a street, it's going to be an Esplanade. But this will, I've got to go down with the engineers to look at the site. There's going to be all sorts of benches there and everything else. So it's just an ongoing situation. But hopefully, I mean, I've got no dates at this moment of time, but I would hope something will be in the next sort of 6 months to a year if it's the Esplanade. But as I say, I've got to make further investigations with the engineers, but everything, you know, we're looking into that direction, and that's where we are at this moment of time.
Brilliant. Well, Councillor Jerry Williams and Rob Potter, both, thank you very, very much indeed. An absolutely gorgeous story.
Thank you. Very pleasure.
Your voice, your story.